I've not been able to sleep since I arrived in the country. So it's like in the course of 5 days, I haven't had more than 2 hours sleep. And I won't sleep until I see something being done. My nightmare started in front of the border where we couldn't, the authorities were very cold, they didn't answer to anyone. And I have to be fair, actually, they did not answer to their own people. And if they don't answer to their own people, you can expect worse to us. So when we approached them, they waved us out. They just like, it's like an irritant came close to them. When my friend and I, we spoke Ukrainian, like really good Ukrainian to them. And it was like, oh, you speak very good Ukrainian. Where are you going to? Stay with us and fight. And when we arrived there, I met some other black guys who told me they've been there since about 11 a.m. Some Ukrainian lady lost consciousness because I was already close to the first barricade. She lost consciousness and they were yelling, Likar ye? It means like, is there a doctor here? Is there a doctor here? And I was with my backpack and I didn't want to volunteer, but because I knew I was going to lose the line and I've been sent back a lot of times, but I still went to rescue this woman who had actually diabetic coma. So we tried to give her some sugary stuff, and then she had some consciousness, so she got back. And I met the Ukrainian soldier who was there, the border patrol guy, and said, please, I was already in the front. Could you please take me back at least to that place? I just rescued the person. And he looked at me and just passed. So I had to go back to the starting point. It continued till midnight. We barely moved an inch, and Ukrainians just kept moving. At some point, the guys brought some wood, and they started making fire, and they started putting hot water, and people could at least have some tea to drink. So we went back to get some tea to drink, and on our way back, the soldier was like, don't go there. He was almost trying to push us with his gun. Don't go there. You guys do not have conscience. You're not letting women and kids pass. And he picked up the phone and called the other guys at the other side and said, don't let these people pass. The Ukrainian girl who was with us took our passports and tried to explain to the lady that these people are humans as well. Clearly, she said, you guys are not our priority. So they letting us pass finally is because we were the last already. No back to push us to anymore.
So finally, I'm free from Putin. I escaped Ukraine. It was a very crazy adventure. It took several days of risk.
So I don't want to look so much into the future. For now, I have a task in front of me. The task is, how can I, in my little way, provide medical assistance to our people? I'm willing to provide to anyone, but people who need most are our people in this case, because they are treated like animals.